Hello everyone, this is Aoi, and welcome back to Token Ranbu, the Swords Behind the Sword Boys. For today's episode, we'll be looking into one of the most cursed swords in the series, Nikkari Aoe, and I just hope nothing goes wrong in this video because of it. Nikkari is our first wakizashi of the series, which is basically a short sword that was used as a backup blade or for fighting in close quarters. Nikkari's name comes from the legend about him, which we'll get to in a bit, and his crest also bears a reference to the ghostly woman he's associated with. Nikkari was smithed by Aoe Sadatsugu around the year 1207 CE, and originally was an otachi with a blade length around 76 centimeters. At some point it was shortened to a long wakizashi, but that in itself is another part of the mystery surrounding Nikkari, as we can only guess who did it and why they shortened it. All we know is that the inscription on the blade was cut off, leaving the incomplete signature of Hashiba Gorozemon no Jo Naga. That in itself gives us a few clues, though, so let's get into it. The first part of the signature, Hashiba, is likely a reference to two of Oda Nobunaga's generals, Niwa Nagahide and Shibata Katsuie. Incidentally, it's also the name Toyotomi Hideyoshi used while he was one of Nobunaga's retainers, likely to curry favor with the two aforementioned men. Regardless, Nikkari was thought to have been passed from Katsuie to Nagahide after the former's death, and then eventually to Nagahide's son, Niwa Nagashige. Nagashige is likely the one who had the blade shortened initially, but it's speculated the full signature once read, Hashiba Gorozemon no Jo Nagashige Shoji, which basically means that the sword belongs to him. Gorozemon was the common name of his father Nagahide, so the family connection makes sense. The first shortening of the blade was perhaps due to it being damaged in battle, but the shortening that cut through Nagashige's name was likely done later. And while the reason is unknown, the most interesting speculation is that, since Nagashige's military career was rife with failure, somebody wanted to erase his signature and make it seem as if it was a reference to his father instead. Nagashige eventually gifted the sword to none other than Toyotomi Hideyoshi, who passed it to his son, Hideyori, who eventually gave it to the Kyokugu family, who owned it up until the late 20th century. After receiving the blade, the Kyokugu clan moved into the Marugame Castle, a notoriously haunted building, believing that Nikkari would keep them safe. Considering they held onto the sword for 400 years, I'd say they made a pretty good bet. But let's back up a bit as to why they would think the sword would protect them from evil spirits in the first place. There are a few theories as to how Nikkari earned his name, but in the interest of time, we'll just touch on the most common one, and the one referenced in the Hanamaru anime. In the late 1500s, Nakajima Shuridayu was lord of the lands around Mount Hachiman. Rumors grew of a demonic presence on the mountain, so he took the sword and headed into the woods to try and see what was going on. As night fell, he encountered a woman and a child. The woman, with an unnaturally creepy grin, set her child on the ground and asked if Nakajima would pick him up. As the child crawled toward him, Nakajima felt that this had to be a trick of the demon, because no mother and child would be wandering about the woods after nightfall, so he sliced through the child with his sword. The mother then asked Nakajima to embrace her instead and continued to advance, so he swung the blade at her as well, causing both of them to vanish. When morning came, Nakajima returned expecting to find two bodies, but was met with the sight of two stone lanterns cut completely in half. He then gave the sword the name Nikkari, as a reference to the creepy grin and laughter of the mother he had encountered that night. Back in the present times, the sword was eventually bought by the city of Marugame in 1997, and currently resides at the museum there, regularly going on display for the public. Now, let's get into some trivia. The white cloth Nikkari wears in his battle outfit is confirmed by his artist to be a Shiro Shozoku, which were sometimes used to cover the bodies of the dead. Nikkari is very bothered by his history, especially the fact that he killed the child, whether a demonic spirit or not. It's implied that this is the reason he could never be a divine or a holy sword, which is confirmed by Ishikirimaru in one of the game conversations. His Kiwame letters include Nikkari coming to terms with his legend and deciding that, if other people say anything, then all I need to do is prove them otherwise. Nikkari's hair is usually covering his right eye, but in some artwork where it's uncovered, that eye is red, as opposed to his normally visible golden one. Red eyes in anime typically denote characters who have evil or demonic traits. Incidentally, Nikkari is portrayed as being rather creepy, especially in Hanamaru, but personally, I think that's part of his charm. And that's the story of Nikkari Aoe. As always, please do like, comment, and subscribe. And next time we'll take a look at the first blade from the rather large Awataguchi school, Nakigitsune. See you then!